Thank you. Something along the way in the future. your opportunity intersects with your reality model and crosses. Some of you will meet that point, and that point will be right on time, right on target, and you will take advantage and discern the opportunity for what it is. Some of you will get there short and the opportunity will pass you by. Some of you will try to pass this business too quick and the opportunity has to be nothing to you. It's all about divine timing. When this thing happens to me, I got there and the opportunity passed me right by because I wasn't ready for it yet. Okay? But if something like that happens, don't be discouraged. I could have been discouraged. I could have went and sat and pouted for a month or two. You know, I sat back, I meditated on it, and I said, man, how can I let this happen to myself? And I made a vow to never let this happen to myself ever again. And I didn't. It doesn't mean that everything I did in business was phenomenal, like everything was a success, you know, I almost hit out the park. But I did pretty damn good. And I saw opportunities for what they were, I analyzed opportunities, I became an expert on understanding what opportunities and how to roll out and push into the future. I began to develop my behavior. I always had it, but sometimes ego can get in the way and blind your vision. You can take illusions to yourself. Which is what I did. That's why I missed out on the opportunity. So with that being said, you know, like I'm telling you, you have to understand. You got to think, and you got to think big, but you also got to expect that the big thing is going to come, and you got to recognize it when it comes. I remember the first time I wrote myself a check for money. The very, very first time. Maybe I talked about the 1 million, but before that, I wrote myself a check for $20,000. Now, that didn't sound like a lot of money. It was like 1993. It's a lot of money. That was a significant amount of money. Back then, the 20K that you can do now, maybe 60K even. And so I wrote myself a check for 20,000, put that check inside of my wallet, and I walked around with it everywhere I went. That was a dedication to myself, right? And I always put an expiration date. So the date that you put in the date field in the check is the date that check has to be passed by. So I put a future date. I had no idea how, when, why, what, where, this was my goal to get to. And what's interesting is, the week later, this guy comes up to me. He's like, hey, I'm interviewing an intern for a company for building websites for my school, my college. He was an exchange student from Saudi Arabia. And I was like, okay, well, I have a company. You knew that. I'm like, well, can you explain a little bit deeper? Like, what do you guys do? He said, well, I'm going to build a website. It's going to be for you. You can keep it. But, you know, the only thing I want you to pay is the hosting fee. And he explained to me what that was. Every month you got to pay a fee for the host. It's a host fee. You got to use the company. That's how long they've been around. Hostgator.com. They've been around since the beginning. That hostgator was like $15 a month or something. It was a low number. I bought the domain name. And at the time, I had a discount healthcare program I was offering. And, the first weekend that we got the spread, I couldn't tell it was wrong, the first weekend on Live, I joined the email group. It was like $45 or $50 to join the email group. This is back when everybody on AOL wanted to get an email. It was on the old IRS account, you know. I forget how it was fax, but it was fax to be a bad man called as well. That was the fax machine. You get on there, but those $65 or $75 that got an email from me about my discount healthcare program. And in 1 weekend, I signed up 4,000 people. 4,000 people signed up in 1 weekend. That was 4,000, probably worth of like $2,950. And so, in that moment, to get to 20,000, I was up to like $50,000. Wow, this is incredible. This is a feature. Long story short, I ended up developing myself a web development company. Startup company called .com Opportunity. I built that company into a multi-million-dollar company, which ended up getting sold to Global Systems, which ended up getting acquired by an Android web company. Made millions of dollars. That was in 2004 by the time all that was done. That was before acquisitions and sales taxes. And all this is publicly available downloaded information online. And the point that I'm making is I set myself a goal for $20,000. way, my goal is too small. The goal is too small. So I can teach you $200,000. And of course, I continue working in the business. I ended up opening up a call center. I opened up a 5,000 square foot call center with telemarketers to do this business. But the money that I made from that teaching of email, I got more money on the email, but it continues to diminish and diminish and diminish. I think you use up the email, which is a very short list back then. I opened up a call center in Fort Lauderdale, over by the Pilot Airport, and put people on the phone, and started selling my place. Before you know it, I was up to 50, 60, 70,000 a month, and then you get the income. Gross. Pay the overhead, pay the phone fee, that's in your pocket line. You didn't have to do the line. That's a phenomenal idea. You start the process, and you have to do the process. Good. start to realize that, all right, I need to adjust the business model, right? Okay? And Mighty Marcus, I'm going to ask you a question. Question for you, Mighty Marcus. Can you try to thank you? You're going to begin to realize, wait a minute, hold on, how do I think this now? Let me take a look at it. Let me change this one. Let me flip this one. Let me see. What if I do this? What if I do this? What if I do this? Thank you. You go all in on something you're truly passionate about.